Hello bakers, it's me, Haley, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to make shaped jello. So all you're going to be needing is some sort of jello. I am using pink starburst flavored jello. Some sort of mold. I'm using this circle silicone mold. You'll be needing a whisk, a half cup measuring cup, and a 1 cup measuring cup, a bowl, and then this is optional, but you also can use Christmas candies. That's how I will be making this Christmassy. So I have the trolley sour trees and some candy canes. I'm using strawberry flavored candy canes. So I'm going to move this all out of the way and then start our first step. So right now you are going to be needing your silicone molds. I'm not going to be making circles because I think that would be very tricky to make circles. So I'm just going to be using this half of my silicone mold. And this is where you're going to want your candies. So my trolley sour trees and my candy cane. So for the candy canes, I am just going to crush them. I don't know what I'm going to crush them with yet, but I will figure something out. So right now you are going to be needing your silicone molds. I am not going to be making circles because I think that would be very tricky to make circles. So I'm just going to be using this half of my silicone mold. And this is where you're going to want your candies. So my trolley sour trees and my candy cane. So for the candy canes, I am just going to crush them. I don't know what I'm going to crush them with yet, but I will figure something out. So I don't know if this is the best way to crush the candy canes, but I just took them out of the bowl and I'm using the end of the whisk to crush them. And I chose the strawberry flavor because it will go best with my jello, but just whatever kind of jello you use would depend on what flavored candy canes you would want to use. And you don't really want to turn these into dust. You just kind of want to crush them so that they're small enough to go into our molds. I'll come back when I'm finished crushing all 3 candy canes. So two candy canes, or this, I just used 1.5 candy canes, has made quite a bit of, it has made quite a few pieces. So I'm just going to start with 1.5 candy canes, also because I have the trolley sour Christmas trees. And I'm going to now open the trolley trees. And again, this candy is optional, but I'm going to get the trolley trees open and now start placing the candies just kind of inside the mold. I'm going to do, I think I'll do 1 Christmas tree per mold. And there are 6 trees on my mold, so I'm just going to start by making 6 molds, and then if I need to do any more, I will then do more. But I don't think I should need to do any more after these, but I guess I don't know yet. So now I'm just going to sprinkle the crushed candy cane. Not very much though. Do like just a little bit per thing. You might also not be able to see the candy very well since my jello is obviously going to be pink. But again, it's your option if you want to use the candy. But that, the candy is just kind of what's making this a little more Christmassy. And if I have some left, I'm going to take these to New Year's. But I am not doing these last three that I'm doing are not really going to be that much Christmas themed, just because it's after Christmas and I'm going to be doing, my last two treats are going to be for New Year's. So I have these done. I'm going to scoot them off to the side and now show you how to make the Jello. You're going to want your bowl, your Jello, your whisk, and your measuring cups for this next step. Alrighty, bakers. So for step one, you're going to want to add 1.5 cups of boiling water to this. So I'm going to get this opened up and pour my Jello mix, and then I'm going to just use a glass bowl to warm up the hot water. And this will probably make quite a bit of Jello, if I have to guess. I've never made Starburst Jello before, but this does definitely smell just like peach Starburst. So I just found this liquid measuring cup thing, and I am going to use this instead of the measuring cups because it will be a little bit more accurate for your water or any liquids. So I'm going to fill it up to the 1.5 mark, which is right there, right by my finger, and then I'm going to put it in the microwave for probably about 2 or 3 minutes. And one quick thing, that when you get your hot water out of the microwave, you're going to want an oven mitt or something to protect your hands because it will be very, very hot. And while your water is either boiling on the stove or in the microwave, you are going to want to get your whisk ready because you will be needing your whisk for the next step, and you also optional can use a spoon instead of a whisk, but I chose to use a whisk. So this next step that we're doing, which is adding the hot water into your mix, is going to have to be a fast process so that your water does not cool down. And my water is now done. So I'm going to grab it out and pour it in just like that, and now you're just going to use your whisk or spoon and just kind of mix it all up, because if you don't mix it all up, then it will have little pieces of the gelatin powder or Jello powder still floating around, and then it'll make it crunchy. And I don't think we quite want crunchy Jello. So this is going to take about 2 minutes to stir all together, and I will come back for the next step. So next step, you're going to want to take this again, and I'm just going to grab a clean towel and just wipe, try to get off some of the hot water that's still in there. And then you're going to, again, want 1.5 cups of cold water. So I'm just going to get my sink running pretty cold water. And then I now add 1.5 cups. Then you're just going to add your 1.5 cup of chilled or cold water in and stir. Just like this. And I'm reading on the box, and it says that it should take about 4 hours to fully chill in the refrigerator, which is how much time I'm pretty sure most jello takes. I'm just going to keep whisking for just a little bit longer because there's still a little bit of stuff in the bottom. And then I will call it good. Start pouring it into the molds. Now you are going to want to move everything out of the way. And because it is now time to pour this into your bowl. So I'm just going to make sure that the side that would be like almost more of the pretty side is down, so that when you look at these from how they're supposed to be, the pretty side will be up. And now, time for the hard part, which is pouring this jello mix into the mold. You're just going to want to go kind of slow and just pretty much fill it all the way. And this part does take a little bit of time just because it is kind of a trick to do. It's also messy because if it, like, these molds aren't, like, they don't stand up all the way, whatever. So some of the jello stuff is dripping out onto the table. I'm just gonna clean up the stuff that spilled. So, sorry about that. I'm just gonna clean up the stuff that spilled. My phone just had an alert, so I don't know if it was recording or not. I'm moving on to my last two, and I'm pretty sure that I'll have to make like 2 or 3 more molds, because I still do have quite a bit of jello mix left. But I'm going to move this into the fridge, but I'm going to first try to get it onto a pan without it spilling. So wish me luck. Okay, so for these last ones, I am going to put some of this crushed candy cane in some of them, but then I'm going to also leave a few molds without any crushed candy cane in them. Just going to put quite a bit of crushed candy cane in like 2 or 3 molds, and then I'm going to just leave the last 3 with nothing. But I would recommend putting your molds, if you have a silicone mold like I do, on a pan before you dump your mix in. Because I didn't do that, and I just had to almost spilled all my mix out of my molds when I was trying to get it onto a pan. And it made perfectly 12 circle molds. One of these bowls did. And don't mind my background noise. But I am now going to take this out to my outside fridge and let it sit in there for probably 4 hours. And I'll try it at about 7:30 tonight. Or try them at about 7:30 tonight. Alrighty, bakers. So, my jello should be just about done. It's not my first time checking on them, though. Special guest, will you get me a butter knife, please?
Yes.
So if you couldn't already tell by the voice, my special guest today... Nope, get a real butter knife. My special guest today is my little sister, Blair. All right, Blair, which one do you want? Okay, ready? Look. So, as you guys know, it's Starburst strawberry flavored Jello, and it has our candies in it. So, Blair, this one is cherry candy. This one's strawberry, blue raspberry, lemon, and green apple. What one would you like?
That one.
And that one. Alrighty. Okay. So,
I wasn't in the video that she was making to make these. I was napping, so.
Oh, Blair, they're falling apart a little bit.
It's okay. Edit that out.
Alright, I'll get a better one, but you can. Alright, Blair, show it to them. It doesn't look very good because this Jello hasn't settled all the way yet, but Blair has just been so eager to try our treats that I made today. So how?
I actually tried it.
How is it? Blair's outside of the camera because she looks very tired. Why did you say ew? Okay, so that's what they look like. Not very appetizing looking, but I'm gonna try it. I think it'll look a little better once we let it settle a little more.
Mm-hmm. Which is tonight, probably, right? Mm-hmm.
So, I made these at 3:30, it's now 6:30. And so that means that these took about 3 hours, but 4 hours would probably be better. So have a very happy 2023 and send me a picture of the treats if you make them, right, Blair?